today.
Right there.
There you go. Thank
you. Just take yourself a seat.
Oh, it's too high. It's sorry.
The two being a long-tailed stingray and then also eagle rays. Now they are the biggest species in the world, so they can actually get up to 3 meters in length.
Wow.
And about 300 kgs. So they do get massive, these ones, but the ones we get in here are a lot smaller.
How many do you have here?
Oh, we reckon we've got about 7 at the moment, but in peak summer we can get up to 15. Yeah, so it's totally random some days.
Ooh, power.
So as you can see in front and behind you is our reef. really quite a unique observatory in that we are floating, we're not sunken down on the sea floor. And so that does mean we get a double perspective of both the open water fish as well as all the bottom dwelling community as well. So we can never really know what we are going to see down here. It is, as I said, all wild. But just these fish that we've got coming through, these are our spotties. We'll also potentially get some of our yellow-eyed mullet. So they're a really big schooling fish and they're really cool to just sit and watch. And then up the front there is our sea pen. So that's the only part of this whole reef that's fully enclosed. And we're just keeping a few species in there for short periods of time to show people what species we do get around here in the Queen Charlotte. So at the moment we've got a blue cod, a couple of moki, a sea perch, and then we've got heaps and heaps of crayfish in there. So they're really cool to check out because they're generally hiding away in the crays and cracks. But the ones in there don't have any threats, so they will just sit out in the open.
So all the mussels here are native or?
Not native, but they are generally found only in New Zealand.
Oh my god.
It's about 9 meters. Yeah, not too deep. We're probably sitting at about 2 meters now.
That is cool.
I'll go chuck some food down. I'll see if I can come in nice and close.
You should see this, come on.
Look at that, it's huge.